TaCRI stands for the Tanzania Coffee Research Institute, which was legally constituted in 2001 when it became legally operational as a stakeholder-owned and managed institute for demand-led research for development. And the reason was, previously, coffee research was under government and growers were not satisfied with what was going on in addressing their most pressing problems. And the pressing problems at that time were issues of low coffee productivity, high cost of production, low coffee prices, and therefore income from coffee growing was unprofitable. Coffee growing became an unprofitable business. So growers wanted a change. Their research is to develop technologies that will address the issues of low productivity, high cost of production, and generate profit from coffee growing. So the pressing problems at that time were for Robusta Arabica coffee. It was coffee leaf rust and coffee berry disease. Each of these diseases can cause yield losses of up to 80%. But cost of control at that time were also very high. Growers spent more than 50% of their cost of production just for the management of these two diseases. Very high cost of production, contributing to the high cost of production. So our major effort was to address the management of these two diseases by developing varieties with resistance to these diseases. We have been very successful. We have developed the 19 Arabica coffee hybrids, which combine high productivity with good beverage quality and resistance to these two diseases. That is an outstanding accomplishment. For Robusta coffee, the major pressing problem, the pressing problem was the coffee wilt disease. This disease kills the Robusta tree and therefore reduces production by 100%. We have been successful over the last 14 years to develop four Robusta coffee varieties that combine resistance to coffee wilt disease with good beverage quality and high productivity. We have released these varieties officially. Therefore, we have 23 improved coffee varieties now available in this country. The challenge we are facing now is the accelerated multiplication and distribution of seedlings of these high-yielding varieties to meet the high demand. The growers know their benefits, and there is high demand for seedlings, and that's where we need to put our effort really to ensure that we replace all the old varieties in this country with these new varieties. The European Union came in from the beginning, and to date, they have contributed about 44% of the operational costs of this institute, while growers have contributed about 40% of the running costs, with the rest coming from the government of Tanzania and our own sources. So we are grateful for the contribution from the EU, really, which led to initiating the change from a government-owned to a stakeholder-owned institute, and have continued to provide consistent support for all these 14 years to support this activity. And the coffee growers have made their own contribution, which almost matches the contribution from the European Union to address these issues. And I'm happy to report that really the growers themselves are very happy with the work being done by their institute. The European Union has always given us support, and they're also satisfied with the way we are utilizing their resources to addressing the most pressing problems of the industry for the benefit of the growers, to improve their income security and livelihoods, and everybody else in the value chain including those who enjoy our coffee.